Hi, this is Mick Elliott from Electronic Specifier. I'm on the Cambridge GaN Devices stand at Electronica. With me is Peter DiMaso, Vice President of Business Development. Peter, two new products from Cambridge GaN Devices at the show. If you'd like to talk us through the first one.
Sure. Good morning, Vic, and thank you. So what we've done recently is introduced a 25 milliohm product that is both dual side cooled and bottom side cooled. And we've done an application of this with our iScan interface on both those products, by the way. And we've done an application here of a 800 volt, 150 kilowatt inverter. Correction, it's 100 kilowatt. Thank you. So what we've done here is created with our 650 volt technology, we've been able to do 800 volts inverter. And the way we do that is by implementing an NPC neutral point connection multi-level inverter. And what we've been able to achieve with that is much higher efficiencies in the inverter itself, achieve and lower the voltage across the transistors, which is actually comes out of the inverter itself and goes to the motor and allows the motor to become much smaller in size and much more efficient, and thereby reducing the size and the cost of the motor itself as well as the inverter, therefore making the whole automobile lighter and more efficient, and either getting more battery range or just saving or being able to get a smaller battery into the car for the same range. So it's an excellent application of the iScan device. And just so you know, iScan, which is our stands for Integrated Circuit on E-Mode GaN, is a Cambridge GaN Devices proprietary interface circuit that makes the whole GaN device easy to use, and very robust, and reduces the overall system cost, and it gives an advantage, and it's really leading edge in the whole GaN market. Okay. And next, I'd like to show you another introduction that we have.
If I could just ask you, this demo you produced in collaboration with...
I'm sorry. Yes, yeah. Good point. Yes. So IFP out of France is our partner on this. They've actually done the design with our help on the inverters, and they've done a great design here. And we have some excellent data that shows the advantages of our GaN compared to traditional technology that you saw just there right now.
So this is typically inverter applications, looking mostly at electric vehicles?
Yes, this is an electric vehicle inverter drive, for an electric motor, correct.
And you're a fabless company, I believe, is that correct? Who produces the silicon, and when might this be ready?
We've publicly said it, TSMC is our foundry,
And when do you expect silicon on this?
Well, we have silicon today. As you can see, these are the actual devices, so they exist today. We have a roadmap that's coming in, many more parts are coming in 2025.
Okay, we've just moved across the Cambridge GaN Devices stand, and we're going to look at a GaN-based motor drive, which Cambridge GaN Devices has worked on with Qorvo. Peter, could you talk us through that?
Sure. So we worked with Qorvo on a eval board here, which was originally a reference design. It uses their PAC556A driver. Now, the beauty of this was that they being Qorvo, were able to reduce the switching losses of their drive by using our GaN. And it was only our GaN that was able they were able to work with. And the reason for that was the iScan that I told you about. It makes it easy to use and more robust. And they were able to interface directly to our GaN. If they tried to use other GaN that's available in the market, they would have needed extra interface circuits. And actually, you can see that in here. Yeah. So you can see those are the external interface circuits that would connect to one of the transistors from one of our competitors. Whereas with us, you can see that goes away, and they can use that space to actually cool the device better. And so they were able to do that. And before this board here had IGBTs on them, and they needed all this space. Now when they replaced it and redesigned the board, you can see all the empty space that's available because we reduced the size of the implementation. So again, very easy implementation. They have two versions. One of them uses our 240 milliohm device, and that can go up to 400 volts of motor drive. And the second board uses our 55 milliohm device, and it can drive up to 800. And these are really motor drives for appliances, compressors, dishwasher pumps, and so forth, the refrigerators, exactly.
And again, is silicon available now? Or?
Yes, these are parts that have been, this is actually from our first generation of products, so yeah, exactly.
Okay. All right. Peter DeMasso, thank you very much.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.